A lot of the technology we use today was not around a while back, like having smartphones that's thousands of times faster than the computer that powered the first moon landing. What if your phone could last 4 days on a charge, or an EV could go twice as far, charge in minutes, and cost less than its internal combustion counterpart? This will be made possible by solid-state batteries, the next generation of batteries. As the name suggests, a solid-state battery is a battery technology that uses a solid electrolyte instead of the liquid or polymer gel electrolytes found in lithium-ion or lithium-polymer batteries. A battery's electrolyte is a conductive chemical mixture that allows the flow of electrical current between the two electrodes. A lithium-ion battery consists of three main layers: a cathode or positive electrode, an anode or negative electrode, a separator, which is an electrical insulator that prevents short circuits and is made of a porous material, and an electrolyte, through which lithium ions move from the anode to the cathode. A battery can be thought of as the electrochemical equivalent of rolling a ball uphill, which requires work to be put into the system and letting it roll back downhill on its own to release stored energy. In a fully discharged cell, the lithium in the cell resides in the cathode. When the cell is charged, work is put into the system to drive lithium ions from the cathode to the anode. In the fully charged state, the lithium ions sit in the anode. When the battery is discharged, these lithium ions are allowed to move back through the electrolyte, and in the process, energy can be extracted from the system, just like the ball rolling downhill can release its stored energy in the form of work. Solid-state batteries still work in the same way as current batteries do, but the change to a solid electrolyte alters some of the battery's attributes. A similar-sized solid-state battery promises to have a higher energy storage capacity, charge significantly faster, a longer lifespan, and a lot safer than a conventional lithium-ion battery. The immediate benefit of switching to a solid electrolyte is the increase in energy density of the battery. Conventional liquid-soaked battery separators are about 20 to 30 microns thick, compared to 3 to 4 micron separators in solid-state batteries, which is roughly 7-fold space saving. A further increase in energy density can be obtained by ditching today's standard anode material, graphite, for a lithium metal anode. A paper published by a group from BMW includes a chart showing a dozen different next-generation cathode materials and three different anode materials. The chart clarifies that the energy density gains from using next-generation cathode materials are limited, unless lithium metal is used as the anode. Traditional lithium-ion cells use a hosted anode in which the host material provides a structure to hold the lithium. For example, in the case of carbon, it takes 6 carbon atoms to hold one lithium atom. If, however, an anode of pure metallic lithium were used, all the carbon in the anode could be eliminated and the energy could be stored in a much smaller volume. However, it has been known that lithium metal anodes do not work with conventional liquid electrolytes due to dendrite formation. Metal can build up on the anode and slowly create dendrites, needle-like formations, and those can extend and puncture the separator between the anode and the cathode, which can cause short circuits and lead to fires or even explosions. It is widely believed that to make a lithium metal anode battery, one needs a solid-state separator which is about as conductive as a liquid but resists dendrite formation and does not react with the metallic lithium. For more than 40 years, the industry has been searching for such a material. In the past few years, materials such as oxides, sulfides, phosphates, solid polymers, ceramics, and even glass have been used as solid electrolytes. Some of the main drawbacks of the lithium-ion batteries we use today, which solid-state is trying to solve, is that cells can lose about a third of their capacity within a decade of use, where over time, compounds in the liquid can corrode internal battery components and can experience degradation or solid material buildup inside, both of which lead to a degradation of battery capacity and overall performance. Then there is the risk of leaking electrolyte and a high flammability, which is a safety risk. Solid-state batteries aren't a new thing at all, but their use in such a heavy-duty application, such as in an automobile, is. They've been in use for many years in small devices like pacemakers and RFID. In the early 1830s, Michael Faraday discovered the solid electrolytes silver sulfide and lead fluoride, which laid the foundation for solid-state batteries. By the late 1950s, several electrochemical systems used a silver ion as the solid electrolyte, but it had some unwanted qualities, including low energy density and cell voltages and a high internal resistance. In the 1990s, a new class of solid-state electrolyte emerged, developed by the Oak Ridge National Laboratory, which was then used to make thin-film lithium-ion batteries. As technology advanced into the new millennium, researchers and companies operating in the automotive and transportation industries experienced a revitalized interest in solid-state battery technologies. In 2017, John Goodenough, the co-inventor of lithium-ion batteries, unveiled a solid-state battery using a glass electrolyte and an alkali metal anode consisting of lithium, sodium, or potassium. Another solid-state battery startup named Quantumscape drew attention in 2018 when Volkswagen announced a $100 million investment into the team's research, becoming the largest stakeholder, joined by investor Bill Gates. In January 2021, Quantumscape revealed performance results of their solid-state battery. After 1,000 charge cycles, the single-layer cells retained 90% of its energy capacity. Quantumscape targets to achieve an energy density of 1,000 watt-hours per liter for their multi-layer cell, which will provide a 40% increase in range compared to the 2170 cell used in the Tesla Model 3, which has an energy density of 713 watt-hours per liter. The main delay is currently caused by the stacking of single-layer cells into a multi-layered battery. Moving from lab production to mass-scale production, solid-state batteries are one of several next-generation battery technologies that can solve the safety issues with lithium-ion batteries to obtain a higher safety, higher energy density, and a longer battery lifetime.